Good morning all, and we are doing control statement. What is control statement? Previous class we have done with the if, elif, with the if, with the nested if we have done, and while loop also we have done. Now continue with the control statement. So if this, though we have already done, just I am going to remind you once. So if test expression, what is test expression? If condition is correct, then statement will be executed. So if statement, see here, num equal 3, what is the value of num? 3. If num greater than 0, it is correct, this statement is a correct, then it will execute this line. Print num, whatever num have value, this will be printed. 3 is a positive number, it will display it is a positive number. If it will come a 0, that will be negative numbers. Print, this is always printed, this message will be always printed if it is greater than 0, otherwise no other message will be printed. Because one if I have used here, if only one condition is there, this only this statement will be executed, otherwise it will exit from this control. So and with the if we can use a else body. Within a if body we can use a else part also. And see here, same example I am using here. If num greater than equal 0, so print positive or 0. Else, see, if this condition correct, so this statement will be executed. Else, this statement will be executed. What does else part in a if body? So if that condition, if condition will be checked, then same after if statement, whatever you have given a statement will be executed. Else, otherwise, what does it? After else part, whatever you have written, that part will be executed. Same. Also, this is a flow chart. If test condition, it is true, body part will be executed. If false, it is false, then else part will be executed. So same example you can try. See here with the elif, num equal, see what I have assigned the value, num equal decimal value I have assigned, it is a float variable. Num equal 3.4, this is a value which is assigned to num. Now this is the next part, by mistake it is written in a same. So num equal 3.4, this is a float value which is assigning to num. Now num greater than 0, this condition will be checked. If it is correct, it is correct because num is a greater than 0, so print positive number. Elif, this is another part. Elif num equal 0, what does print? 0. This is another in our next line. So elif num equal 0, it will check the number. What is the value of num? It is a 3.4. But it is a comparing equality, it is checking with the 0, it is wrong. This statement will never execute because this value is a containing the value 3.4. Now it will check the condition, it is a greater than 0, this condition is a correct, then this statement will be executed. Now it is also checking here, एलिफ नम इक्वल इक्वल जीरो. इफ दिस वैल्यू मस्ट बी जीरो एंड दिस मैसेज विल बी अपियर एंड दिस विल बी इग्नोर. एल्स इफ बोथ आर इनकरेक्ट देन इट गोज टू द एल्स पार्ट. Print negative number. Thank you. This print message will be printed. So what does if elif? If that condition is a correct, that statement will be executed. Otherwise, elif go for a next condition. If that is also wrong, then it goes to the else part. It's the same I have written with the nested if. If float. What is float here? This is a type casting. If normally I am getting value with the input, that will be string type. Now I am converting which I am getting with the string into a float value. So you can get a value here in a num. If num greater than equal zero, if you are inputting any value here, it will check with the num that must be greater than equal zero. Then inside this is a nested if. If num equal equal zero, it will print a zero. Else, if these statement are incorrect, then it will go for an else part. Else print positive number. Else, this is a else of inside a nested, and this else for a this if. Else negative number. This will be positive number. It will check with the zero or given number. This is a inner part, and this is a outer part which will be executed with the negative number. So if this statement is incorrect, then it will go for a this part. And inside of this, if this is a incorrect, it will go for a this condition. And in this will be executed, if both are incorrect, it will go for a last. See here, comparison operator I am using. What is comparison operators means? If you want to check the equality, greater than, less than, greater than equal, less than equal, you can write all these comparison with the if statement. See here, x equal 5. What is the value of x? It is a 5. Now I have to comparing with the 5. If x equal equal 5, it is correct because x have already value 5. I am comparing with the 5. This two time equal operator means it will check the equality of given number. So print equal 5. So this message will be printed. And this is another condition. If x greater than 4, it is also correct because x is a greater than 4. So this message also can be print greater than 4 because its value is a 5. So this is called greater than. This is greater than equal. Greater than equal means whatever value you are assigning to x greater than equal 5. This is a comparison with the this. This is called comparison operator. Print greater than or equal 5. It is a not a greater than but equal 5. This condition is also correct. Now, if x less than 6, it is also correct because what is the value of x? 5. It is also less than 6. It is also correct. Print less than 6. This message also execute. Now, if x less than equal 5. Less than, it is not a less than, but equal to 5 is correct. This statement will be execute. Now here, with the not equal, what is it called? Not equal. So if x not equal 6, it is not a equal with the 6, it is correct because it is a less than 6. So it is a not equal to 6. So this message will be appear. So you can use a equal, greater than 4, greater than or equal 5, less than 6, less than or equal 5, not equal 6. These all statement which I am comparing here, these all are true with the given value. So any condition you can apply with the if x equal 5 means comparison with the equal, greater than equal, less than equal, and not equal. This is called not equal. Remember all these operator, these are called comparison operator. So now one-way decision. One-way means if one is a correct, then one statement, so many statement can be executed. See here, x equal 5. What is the value of x here? It is a 5. Print before 5. Here it will print the this message before 5 will be displayed. If x equal 5, this condition will be checked. Print is 5. Print is still 5. Print third 5. This is a, these all three statement will be executed because there is a no else part, no elif part. So all three parts will be executed with the this condition. This condition is correct because x have a 5 value. So it is a comparison with the 5. Now print afterward 5. Print before 6. This message you can write here. This will be if x, you can write any condition, print is 6. This means here also you can write a condition. This is a flow chart. X equal to 5. Kya x 5 ke ek barabar hai? Yes. Hamara kya hai? Yes hai. Condition correct hai hamari. So then क्या करेगा, ये वाली एग्जीक्यूट करेगी ये स्टेटमेंट, ये भी एग्जीक्यूट करेगा, ये भी एग्जीक्यूट करेगा, देन ये एंड होगा. अगर नहीं है, इफ इट इज नो, देन डायरेक्टली इट विल एंडेड द दिस कंडीशन. सो ऑल दीज कंडीशन आर करेक्ट, सो दीज विल वर्क अकॉर्डिंगली. सो दीज टाइप ऑफ ऑपरेटर यू कैन बी कंपेरिजन, और दिस इज कॉल्ड वन वे डिसीजन. ओनली वन डिसीजन इज देयर. This is a correct. Otherwise, no other statement is there. Directly, it will exit. So, nested decision also there with the flow chart. See here, x equal 42. What is the value of x here? It is a 42. So, if x greater than 1, it is correct. X is a greater than 1 because x have a 42. Now, print more than 1. So this message will be executed. In our next, if x less than 100, less than 100, yes, it is a less than 100. This is a correct because it is a 42 value. Print less than 100. This message will be printed. Print all done. So all these lines will be executed. See here. X greater than 1. What is the value of x? 42. So this statement, and here it is checking x less than 100. This is also correct. This will be executed, then it will end it. All done. Otherwise, if these are incorrect, directly it will end with the given statement. Now visualize block. How to visualize a block? Block means one block. See here, x equal 4. If x greater than 2, this is a correct. This is a one block. Print bigger. It is a bigger. Else, print smaller. This statement should be in the next line. Else, what does it? Print smaller. So this is a one block. This is called one block. And while you are executing your statement with the comparison, so that particular block will be executed. You can also see here with the diagram, x equal 4. This value x with the 4. Now, if it is not, print no bigger and it will directly exit. If greater than 2, this condition is correct, yes, print bigger. Then this statement will be executed. Otherwise, you can print it is a smaller, not bigger written. It is a, you can write a, it is a smaller. Also exit from a loop. So block means one condition you can apply with the particular block, and that particular block only execute with the given statement. Now multi-way, how you can check multi-way with the if statement. You can see here x equal 20. What is the value of x? 20. If x less than 2, less than 2, no, it is small. This print will be printed. This statement will be printed small. Elif x less than 10, what does it? Print medium. So this will message will be print, else print large, because our value greater than 2 or greater than 10. So this statement will be executed, all done. You can write any message, you can print any message with the print statement. Now see the diagram here also. X equal 20, this is a correct one assigned with the 20 value. Now it is comparison with the x less than 2. If it is correct, it will display the small, because it is a correct. 2 is a less than x, it is a correct, it will display small. If no, if it is no, then it will print a large or all done this. Otherwise, it will display the medium. So such type of condition you can apply. How to use multi-way with the if statement? See, x equal 5. This is a value assigned to x. If x less than 2, this is a previous one. Print small, elif. This is a previous one. Now you have to check with here. X less than 2, print small, elif. X less than 10, medium, multiple. Multi-way you can use either one statement with a multi-way. See, statement is a one, declaration is a one, but you can use multi-way with the one variable. So x is comparison with the 10, less than 10, print medium. Elif x less than 20, it is big. Elif x less than 40. So this is a, this multi-way statement large. Elif less than 100, print huge, and else print general. So these multi, with the one statement you can use multi statement with the comparison. So multi-way comparison in a one variable, multi-way we can comparing with the these all operators. Now there is a one program, so I'll run also this program. See here, write a program to find largest among three numbers. You have to input a three numbers, then which is a bigger number, which is a biggest number, then you can find with the if statement. See here, num equal, num1 equal, this I am performing in that. So I am using with the so these variable I have to perform num1, num2, num3. See, num1, num2, num3, these two three value I have to get from user input. Now if num1 greater than num2 and num1 greater than num3, so this line will be in the next line. And if num2 greater than num, this is a comparison with the num3, then it will print the this, and otherwise it will print the largest number. See here, so what is our program? program is a write a program to find the largest number. Here I can write a question also with the command line. Program, write a program to find largest among the three numbers. This is a question. Now I am using num1. What is num1? It is a variable. Equal is a assignment operator. What is int here? This is a type casting. If I am not using these all three with the int variable, so what does whatever I am getting with the input? This is the inner part. This is the input part. Whatever I am getting by using input function, it will be string type. So this int function is a for type casting. From string to number, it will convert and it will store in a particular variable. So here, these all three value I am getting. Now, if num1, this one, greater than num2, second variable, and num1 greater to num3. So num1 will be a comparison with the first. This block will be checked, then again num1 will be checked with the num3. All three will be executed, then print num1 is a greatest largest number. This message will be appear with the print statement. Elif num2, this is for second value. Num2 will be compared with the num1, and num2 will be compared with the num3. So num2 will be compared first with the num1, and then num2 will be compared with the num3. Then it will print is the largest number. Num2 is a largest number. It will display here. Else, what does it? Else, if both these statements are not correct, then it will go in a last part. This part will be executed. Num3 is a largest number. So question can be write a Python program to input any three numbers and find the largest number, find the greatest number. So find the maximum number. So also in this also you can input a three numbers, find the lowest value, smallest value. So you can comparison with the this operator must be changed. This operator should be, you have to for change this like this. So you can create a program yourself. So all these variables you have to get. Now you have to compare with the all two value and you have to display the statement. See, now I am running program. Find the maximum. Value. I'm storing either dot py, you have to store. See here, this statement also with the formatted here. That's why it is running error. You can view here. This is a enter the first number. I am inputting 20, then 30, then 60. So 60 is a large, all two conditions which I have given, these are not comes true, then automatically go to the third condition. 60 is a largest number. If you are, I am talking about the smallest number I have to find. So this will be printed. the only you have to do operator change, which you have done with the greater, you have to put the reverse that operator. So that also you can find the smallest value. You can write a both program together, copy the all the contents of the this program to the another. So just write a program, find the greatest, and write a program to find the smallest value. Both program you can do with the changing of operator. So this is a complete. Now this is another program. Calculate the electronic bill using the different condition. For first 100 unit, there is a 150 per unit. For next 100 unit, 3.75 per unit. For next 100 unit, 4.25 per unit. For rest unit R, 5.65 per unit. This is a question. Now what I have to do here? See, current, this is a variable. What is current? This is a variable. Equal is a assignment operator and input. Enter the current meter reading. This line will be appear, and this will be in a next line. So current, this line will appear. Here you have to input a value, current reading, whatever your meter reading. This you can do practical also. That the same with the your whatever your meter value over there. Previous, this you have to get. What was the previous reading and what is the current reading? Now this will be in the next line. So here both the reading, current and previous, I have inputted here. Now total is a one variable. Equal is a assignment operator. Current minus previous, what will be? So current minus previous, previous reading will be minus, and current, only current. With the whole reading, you have to note down previous reading. Now what is the current reading? You have to minus with the current with the previous reading. So now it comes in a total. Now you have to apply with the total, with the if condition. If total less than equal 100, means it is a whatever you are getting after deducting the previous reading. So what? Total less than equal 100. So it is a less than 100. So bill equal total into 1.5. This is the charges will be calculated. 1.5 will be stored in a bill. Now, if total greater than 100, if it become a more than 100 and total less than 200. This is for 100 to 200 unit. So bill equal 100 into 1.5 plus, this will be added with the total minus 100. Total will be minus with the 100, and what will be calculate? 3.75, it is a given. 3.75, this value will be calculated. Elif, this is the next line. And this will be the next value. This is calculate with the 3.75. LF total greater than 200 and total less than 300. This will compare 200 to 300. So your bill will be calculated 100 into 1.5. This is the first bill, plus 100 into 3.75. This is a under 200. This will be calculated total minus 200 into 4.25 paisa. Yes, see, this will be calculated. Otherwise, it will calculate it as a 5.65 paisa, this one. So else, bill will be calculated same. You have to copy it with the this plus total minus 300. This value will be calculated. See, it is a big program, but nothing difficult. Just you have to make a comparison with the if statement, this, and print bill. Whatever you are calculating in a bill that will be printed is a total amount. This you can do previous from your electricity bill. You have to note down on previous reading and current reading. So you have to deduct the current reading with the previous, then calculate as it is. You can make your own program with the your electricity bill. So try this, and time will also about to over.